Enter into the Noosphere, the mega art of Brian Carleton. Each piece absolutely extraordinary in size and scope, with intricate details that make his work stand out from the crowd. Brian has an eye for detail and attention to detail that makes him unique amongst his fellow artists. Sturdy, colorful, and textured, Brian's work features intriguing patterns of shapes and figures that takes the viewer out of their comfort zone and makes them dare to think beyond themselves into the world of art and afterlife.
Brian, welcome. And tell us a little bit about these paintings right behind you.
I lived in Kentucky in the 1980s, and I had started my landscape commission work, but I was also at night in the studio tinkering around with symbols and images, and began a series I called the Red Square Theory.
Yes, tell me about that.
That series became important to me after boiling down symbols and colors and trying to decide if I could do geometric abstract work. And it's also can be coined hard edge illusionism. But I was able to do research, and I liked artists like Victor Varsarelli. And of course, later I did really get a big kick out of Jackson Pollock's work. But I was also remember in rural Kentucky, and that area that I was in was a crafts area. The women made quilts out of pieces of fabric, and I don't know if it was intentional or not, but I began doing a pattern with the red square, and that's how the series began those many years ago. So this painting is called Three Views of Christ in Ascension. There is three views in this painting. Here is view one, or the first view. Here is view two, kind of a close-up. And here is view three. And you see the human figure, the Christ figure. This is rather complicated for me because the orange, the fire in this, had to be put on last, but putting it on, I could have destroyed the work. I could have completely overcooked it, because mm-hmm. you have to know when to start and stop on these kind of things.
Yeah.
So this one for sure has a name, and it's Jacob's Ladder. And that's a difficult theme, you know, where this would be the ladder. So, it also has a mosaic background, and the way these mosaics are made is by cutting up old paintings. So maybe a painting got hurt, maybe it got ripped, or maybe it just looked awful, which always happens. What am I supposed to do? Throw them away? No? You know what? Let's cut them up and we'll paste them on
the surface.
Yeah. Now this one, I don't believe I have titled. But it does have some good memories for me because I was in that church loft and I was painting, and I happened to have a job after school program called the GATE program, and I had a group of kids come and help me paint this. So when they saw this piece, I called it a mural, group mural art project, and I gave them different colors. I gave one blue, one orange, gave them a paintbrush. So just have at it. And that's what they did. They went to town, and that's how we got the background here. This piece is entitled Visions in the Noosphere. So maybe we should talk a little bit about the Noosphere.
Yes, please.
So it's a word coined by Teilhard de Chardin, and the word is trying to describe man's thought globe. So right now, all the knowledge contained for our universe that man knows is this much knowledge. Now, everything outside of man's knowledge, everything beyond this thought globe, belongs to God, because the globe, as we learn more about the universe, the globe is growing, but to what extent it grows and the outcome of man, what happens to man, is not yet known. Now, there's, you know, visionaries that would say certain things about that, and Teilhard de Chardin did have a theory that he thought it would reach a point of, but I'll just leave it at that. So my paintings are just playing around in the Noosphere. It's like this one here.
Taking a picture from farther away so I can see that one. You've got so many big, huge paintings here. This is your complete life's work of the news from the Noosphere, right?
This is my 9/11 painting after the planes flew into the World Trade Center. So I did enter the competition for it, the design competition. I was one of 5,200 entries that were accepted. So I used a lot of different techniques to get this one together, and it's divergent elements like the mosaics from old cut-up canvases, and the background, and I love this purple through here.
Mm-hmm, me too.
But then it still has the main element of the red square. And there's actually another technique that shows up in this one. If you see, this is where you put netting down, and then you use a spray can to on the netting, and it bleeds through and leaves a pattern. This is a triptych. So it has three panels, and this first panel evolves patterns. Although everything is still pretty static, something's happening. So that's the way you read this. You read the first panel, and then something's happening in the second panel that maybe there's something going on that we need to think about. And then in the third panel, that's when the red squares appear to be ripped off of the canvas. And that's why they're moving like they are. This work would be very suitable for a reading room or a library or anything like that.